Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I got several videos to make. I already made one about Christmas. This is my second one. Brothers and sisters, I ask you to continue to pray for us. As the Lord has showed me that all the quack doctors, witch doctors here, have been using this house before the Lord put me here to rent this house, to do all kinds of spiritual magic in this house. And the Lord has shown me that the powers and principalities over this city, over the city of Davao, Philippines, oh, they're all tore up about me being here. And God put me here, brothers and sisters. I've asked you to pray in the past. I ask you to pray again. And I'll just tell you, look, people make quip little statements and cute little statements and say, oh, just, you know, rebuke them in Jesus' name. Let me tell you something. That's what we know. There's lots of things in the spiritual realm that we don't know. We just have little hints about it in the Bible. As an example, in Daniel, when Gabriel came to Daniel, he said, you know, Daniel, you know, beloved of God, I tried to come to you 21 days ago, but the prince of Persia withstood me. And then your angel, your prince, Michael, the archangel Michael, so there are also positive principalities. There's the principalities of fallen angels that God gives authority over sin, hierarchy of demonic realms to fallen angels. Demons and fallen angels are not the same thing. Demons are your little imp spirits. Fallen angels are fallen angels that are the principalities. Okay, and forces of darkness in high places. All the way up to Satan, who's the chief of the fallen angels. They're different than the demons. Demons are the disembodied spirits of the Nephilim, FYI. Okay, so angels also have hierarchy. There's guardian angels, there's higher level angels, and then as we know, there's Gabriel, the messenger angel who says he told the father of John the Baptist, behold, I stand in the presence of God Almighty. He had all, you know, power and authority to make his father, Zechariah, to be dumb, not be able to speak until John the Baptist was born because of his lack of faith, his doubt and unbelief. And then Michael is the prince over the nation of Israel. You know, there's different archangels. Some of them is written about in these extra-biblical documents. You know, they have different names and they have different functions supposed to be. And we know that God has millions of angels. And I'll just tell you this. We do not worship angels. Number two, people always say, well, the Holy Spirit's doing this and the Holy Spirit's doing that. Listen, God has millions of angels, and they serve some purpose. They do some function, and all those functions we don't know about because the Bible doesn't tell us the details of what they do. So lots of times when people think it's a spirit movement, God is directing his angels to actually do things. There's angels that do healing. There are angels who guard, angels that bind demons, all this kind of stuff of angelology, okay, that we just don't know. As I said, the Bible gives us hints, and I just gave you one, that Gabriel, one of the highest level archangels, was withstood by the principality over the nation of Persia, which is modern day Iran, for 21 days until Michael, the prince over the prince angel, the archangel, or principality angel, holy angel over the nation of Israel, was able to come and bind that spirit and hold back that spirit and allow Gabriel to come through. So this forces of darkness, as the Bible says, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against powers, principalities, forces of darkness in high places. Let me tell you something. It's not just that simple and that easy. You're talking about some little demon spirit. Someone's got a little demon in them from homosexuality or doing drugs or whatever, and you cast it out, and they repent and all that. That's one thing. We talk about principalities and powers and forces in high places. And even in Jude, it talks about giving respect to dignitaries. Now, I've done videos about this, and I guess I have to repeat it a little bit because people don't know what I'm saying who haven't watched my other videos. God gave Satan authority to enter Judas. The Bible says Satan entered Judas, and Judas betrayed Jesus. Now, Satan wanted to stop Jesus from doing whatever he was going to do. Satan wasn't sure exactly what Jesus was going to do. He probably thought that Satan thought he was going to become, you know, take over Israel at that time. You know, because it says if they'd have known they were crucifying the Prince of Glory, then they wouldn't have done it, the Bible tells us. So Satan obviously didn't know, as a brother in Seattle used a good expression, it's controlled opposition. Satan is controlled opposition. The Lord uses Satan for his glory. Demons have authority from our sin, from our sin. I start trying to talk to my dead relatives. Next thing you know, I start hearing voices. I become demonized. Why? Because God said, don't do that. I did it, and so there's consequences. What's God's purpose? To lead me to repentance. To lead me to repentance. This is the job that these demons and fallen angels have. As an example, there's a principality over homosexuality, principality over every city, I guess, over every country, as it talks about the prince of Persia. A principality over the nation of Persia that has control over the king of Persia at that time, over the president, prime minister, whatever, of Iran. So they have this power. So people that go around trying to cast down principalities and all this stuff, God didn't give us that authority. As even it says that, you know, even the archangel, you know, the angel of the Lord didn't rebuke Satan. He said, the Lord rebuke you, Satan, to Satan. So there are levels that we are authorized. You know, in other words, let me say it this way. Let's just say you go to San Francisco. I've mentioned this in videos before. You go to the Castro district, which is the homosexual district of Castro. Now, what are we called to do there? Okay, we are called to evangelize and win those gay people to salvation and get them to repent and come to the Lord. Now, the Bible says that Satan has blinded their eyes, so we're supposed to pray that God will unblind their eyes so that they can see the truth in love and get saved and repent. And if all the gay people in San Francisco became born again tomorrow, then the principality of homosexuality over San Francisco would lose all of his authority. That's how we would destroy the principality over San Francisco. But there are people who think they can go call down and knock down this through prayer. God didn't call us to do that. There are people called to have the heavens opened. Now, there's what intercessors do is call for a breakthrough, like the archangel Michael made a breakthrough for Gabriel, the holy angel, the archangel Gabriel, to come to Daniel and give him the message of the Lord. And that's true. But the prince of Persia was still in authority. He didn't get removed from his authority over Persia. He stayed there. And so all these details in the Bible, we just have hints of what they mean. So what the Lord told me that I had no idea about, just to tell you the news, is that the key to revival, the key to winning this city, all of these witch doctors that have been meeting in this house are connected all the way to the top of the food chain of the powers and principalities and forces of darkness. And God put me here, and it's got the highest levels attention because I'm here. And the Lord has shown me they even send reinforcements in here by the thousands. So I ask you to pray for me. I have no fear because I'm walking with the Lord and I'm praying over my family. I need your prayers because the Bible says one can put 1,000 to flight, 2 to 10,000, can 2 to put 10,000 to flight, and so on and so on. You multiply that. I've asked and getting in contact with local pastors here who are spirit-filled pastors, and there are lots of pastors, and they're not spirit-filled. You know what I'm saying? I got to get a hold of some full gospel preachers, and most of the full gospel preachers I know are in a remote area, and they never went to, you know, never even went to like to the fifth grade. Not that they can't do it, but I need some preachers that know something who are spirit-filled to come here and help me. And I know God will send a breakthrough in here. And this is not just some simple casting out demon. We're coming against the highest levels. But the Lord told me, brothers and sisters, this is the word that the Lord told me. The key to bringing revival and changing this whole city is in this spiritual situation in my home. And I know the Lord in this house I'm renting. And I know the Lord put me here for His purpose and His plan. And it's this experience is at 100 times higher pay grade than I've ever operated. After 13 years serving the Lord, I know lots of things. If you've been watching my videos, I know lots of things. But there's lots of things I don't know and lots of things I've only read about. And I've cast out demons from about 20 different people. These little imps, these little low-level demons. It's a whole other ball game. So I'm just telling you all, you guys, this who are intercessors, to appreciate what I'm trying to ask you to do. So all of the little, you know, cliches, you know not what you're speaking about. What I need is serious brothers and sisters to intercede for me and for the Philippines and for the city of Davao. I ask you to pray. Because unless the Lord builds the house, those that labor in vain. Psalm 127, I need your prayers. I need a breakthrough. I need the wisdom on what to do. I mean, I'm protected. I'm praying over my family. We're walking in protection, but it's like a hindrance. It's like a brass ceiling over this place. I can still pray, but it's just like a huge, huge hindrance. And I have to keep battling it. You know, it's trying to wear me down. But I can still get the breakthrough, but it's not an open heaven. It's not easy. So what I need, brothers and sisters, is your immediate prayers, your immediate breaking through. Help me break through. And you know, there's power in unity among God's people. I need your prayers and unity to shake this place. Even as in the book of Acts, it says they prayed in unity and God shook the place and sent a revival, you know, and poured out his spirit a second time there in, I believe it's Acts chapter 5, Acts chapter 6. So, Acts chapter 5. I need that, brothers and sisters. I need your help to pray for that. And God will, you know, give me the keys to the city through this situation. So I thank the Lord for it. It's such a high level above anything I've ever operated at. You know, I have no fear. I'm just ignorant of exactly what to do. Let's put it that way. And this is, like I said, this is not just your, you know, casting a demon out of somebody. I already did that many times and been involved in that many times. Praise the Lord. It's by his name. But you're talking about high level stuff here. We're talking about principalities who are in authority from God, who have authority in this place because of all the evil and sin and all that stuff, all the evil in this place, like all places. But this is a pretty evil place, much more than where I came from in North Carolina. So, brothers and sisters, I ask for your prayers to help me get the wisdom to break through, and that God would send godly pastors here and church leaders and elders. You know, the Lord has already given me two pastors, a pastor from Nigeria that I met, who's a Pentecostal, that I met about 30 minutes from here, and we just ran into each other, and then I talked to him about doing a crusade. He invited me to do an evangelism crusade with him, and then the Lord spoke to me to invite him to come here and pray with me. And then I met a lady who is a leader in a church, a Pentecostal church, and then she's going to ask the pastor. She told me she's going to ask the pastor to let me speak in their church. But I'm going to ask the pastor to come here and pray with me. Maybe he knows more about it than I do because he's from here. Even though I've been here for 7 years, there's lots of things I don't know. Brothers and sisters, thank you. And I've got another video to make that's a very important teaching that the Lord gave me for the new year coming.